Hey guys, OuterOrange here with some Firewatch. So we're going to start the game and I'm gonna do it all over this one. So I accidentally got interrupted while I was trying to do the first recording, so I'm re-recording. It's okay, I didn't get too far, I only got like 10 minutes in. But let's do this. I'm pretty excited. Boulder, Colorado, 1975. You see Julia. She's about your age, late 20s, laughing with well-dressed professors and grad students from nearby CU Boulder. You, Henry, are out drinking with your pals. You approach her. You are drunk. So you ask, so what's your major? Oh, and you're pretty. You slur the word major and it smells like whores. You give an awkward smile. I was under trained biology, she says, and I'm a professor. Cool, you reply. What's yours? She asks. She sniffs the air. Toxology? Was that a burn? You ask. She says, definitely. Where did you hurt your feelings? She asks if you want to split a cheeseburger. 1 week later, you are Julia's boyfriend. I'm someone's boyfriend. I'm a boyfriend. I am boyfriend. Alright, so, the controls are a little, juggly. See how it's, like, a little bit, jumpy, I guess is the best way to put it. I guess they did it on purpose. I haven't gone too far yet. To really know. You date for over a year. She drives you absolutely nuts. It's great. You move in. You share an apartment near the school with a view of the mountains. You two drink beers out of the deck. You drink beer just about anywhere. Life is good. Sounds like my boyfriend. He likes beer. Julia wants to get a dog. There's a scruffy undersized beagle. Julia is in love. She wants to bring it with her to class. There's also an imitating but gentle-eyed German shepherd. Nothing bad could happen to Julia while walking this dog. It's badass. I picked the German Shepherd the first time. I'm still gonna pick the German Shepherd. Mostly because, I don't know, it's a German Shepherd and they're pretty. Mayhem's an excellent dog. He loves wrestling with you in the park and goes with Julia on her runs. Even though he's too big to bring to school, Julia loves him all the same. Mayhem is a friend, child, and pet all rolled into one. See? Good choice, in my opinion, anyway. I'm sure the other one's not bad either. 1979. You talk out on the deck. It's summer, 9:30 p.m. and the heat still radiates off the high desert. What do you think about kids? She asks. Kids? They're not very smart or good at much. I'm saying if you and I have some. A couple little idiots. So like, if it were me, I would definitely go with this one. Because, I mean, I'm 22. In college. Screw kids. But they're like in their late 20s, probably 30s now. They would probably want a kid. That would be pretty great. In that case, we should probably get married. Yeah, I would like that, you say. These kids are going to be screwed up enough. It's probably for the best that their parents are hitched. You say, she's absolutely right. So, in my opinion, I'm assuming she like dies or something. Because obviously this guy's going on a hiking trip. From the looks of it. Without her, clearly. 1980. It's a Thursday night and Julia is 4 hours late. She doesn't call, you're worried, and getting angrier by the minute. She walks in after going to bed. She's not quite drunk, but she's clearly been having a fun time. You fight when she gets between the sheets. I was a little weird about this one, I wasn't really sure. You call her consider an asshole. She tells you to fuck yourself and do not be such a baby. You call her selfish. She knows you mean it and it hurts her feelings. The other choice was better. I actually chose the right side the first time. I was just curious what the side was like. 1981. Julia still likes to draw. She draws plants from her research. She draws all the places you go. She draws you. And you pose and flex like He-Man, or you frill look like a Victoria's Secret model. I like the He-Man. You look awesome. Alright. See how it's like reddish and stuff? I'm always huge about colors. Red always indicates for me that something angry or bad or aggressive. That's always the kind of... And I feel like this is like his thoughts or something. He's like thinking about this as he's hiking, I guess. That's just my personal thought. I don't actually know. What does this say? Two Forks Lookout Tower, 8 more miles still. Oh, sorry, there's something over me. I was looking at the scenery. 1982. During the summers, you and Julie enjoy walking Mayhem at night. There's a festival in town. It brings in folks from faraway places. One of them tries to mug you with a knife. Mayhem runs away. Mayhem, move, fuck, the dog, Julia yells. She gets frustrated and she has trouble speaking when she is stressed. You confront the attacker and you scare him away. You reach into your pocket, you've got a gun, and threaten to kill him. You manage to scare all three of you. He runs away. Julia asks to take a different path from the day forward. You say okay. You don't want to go that way either. From then on, you walk by the river. 1984. Plantstaff Kids gets waylaid by work. Julia gets offered a job at Yale. Yale is in Connecticut, 2,000 miles away. It is a great job. Associate Department Chair. She wants to move. You absolutely do not. I'm not really big on long-distance relationships. I think it can work. I don't disagree with it. But, I mean, I've been with this girl for, like, a couple of years now. And hell, apparently I want kids. Why the heck would I want her moving? You tell her that means you two won't have a family. She says that's bullshit. She's totally right. She asks if her taking the job means you won't come with her. You say yes. Again, bullshit. But she decides not to take it. 1985. Julia is asking to leave Boulder on paid leave after having an episode. She lost in on a colleague for borrowing books that were important to her research. She didn't remember she had happily loaned them to him just 2 days prior. She was found crying in the stairwell. You say that maybe you guys should talk to someone about it. You make burgundy and drink wine to try and forget about it. Personally, I like option two. I'm gonna go with option one. After seeing multiple doctors and having many tests, they are worried that Julia might be suffering from an early onset dementia. She is 41. You both decide to keep it a secret for now. Okay, so this is actually where I stopped. So now up to this part, I don't know what's going to happen. Yeah, apparently I'm like not moving. I'm just chilling here. Oh, journal. Journal. Oh, it's all the stuff that he's been writing. Aw. Mayhem is getting older. He's got silver hair down his back and then slows down at night. You and Julia walk into the bar to see your friends and it feels like nothing has changed. Julia goes back to university. 1987. Julia's implication gets worse. She can't remember things in class. Her research is in the shambles. She drives her car to the next town over for no particular reason and she has to be brought home by the police. She is devastated. She is sent home on permanent medical leave. Some days you get the Julia who calls you a dope and an unborn child like idiots. Other days, you get a stranger. She pulls you into bed to make love. After 5 minutes, she goes into a panic, believing her dad is at the door. Damn. You tell her family. They are crushed and begin to make trips to and from their home in Australia to visit her. For a while, your friends come by with little things to brighten the day. She gets worse. 1988. You spend your days following Julia around the house. You count the seconds between the two weekly visits from Daniel the nurse. He suggests that Julia could live somewhere else, somewhere with 24-hour care, a home. It sits with you for a couple months. You decide to move her into a full-time care facility. You are determined to take care of her yourself. Okay, well, personally, I feel like it's at a point where I can't do anything about it. Clearly, the past couple months haven't been making it happen. Why would anything change from then on out? So I think maybe a full-time care facility might help. And we are hiking again, as we love hiking. I personally am highly enjoying the interesting colors of this game. It's not like it's like specific colors. It's not like a blending kind of colors, if you know what I mean. Like yellow is yellow and brown is brown. It's not like combined with yellow and brown, if you know what I mean. I can't exactly explain it, but ooh, look, a deer. Hi, deer. Bye, deer. Okay, her family agrees with your decision. You find a fantastic place in Boulder and move her there. You see her every day, then every other day. You go out to the bar with your old friends, it's not the same. You get the feeling that every wife tells her husband, if you ever put me in a home like Henry did, I will cut your balls. You slowly decide not to see your old friends that much. Oh gosh, that's so mean. I mean, it was a pretty understandable decision, like, they don't know. Julia's sister Susan moves to Boulder to be close to her. She visits her every day. You go with her some of the time. Susan buys you an old typewriter, urges you to use it so you won't see a therapist. You won't. You always really like Susan. Ooh, kinky. Months go by, Mayhem dies. Julia doesn't remember him when you tell her. Sometimes it takes her a minute to lock in on you. In the back of your head, you believe it's because you see her less and less. And seeing her less and less makes her forget you more, you think. Summer's coming and you see an ad in the paper for a job. You take it. You take the job! Take it! Sorry, I'm a dork. I kind of knew this was going to go sad, but still. Loading. Oh, don't put a Horizon Zero Dawn on me, please. Just kidding. Alright, so we're at the tower. Enter the lookout tower. Let's go. Like forcing me to walk. Turn on the power. Just like his old thing or something. I heard something stop.
This is Thoroughfare Tower. Come in.
Where's the radio? There's the radio.
I know you're there. Your lights are on.
Hello? Whoever this is?
It's Henry, right?
Yeah.
I'm Delilah.
Yeah, that's what the guy said on the phone.
So, what's wrong with you?
Excuse me?
People take this job to get away from something. So, what's wrong?
What's wrong with you?
That's a great idea. Go ahead.
Look, I just hiked for 2 days, so I don't really follow whatever it is you're doing right now.
You take a stab at what's wrong with me.
Fine. Then can I, sleep forever?
Sure, buddy. Okay, now go ahead.
These are my choices.
You're just gonna wait me out on this? Ugh, fine. But I'm gonna take a second here and have a guess about you. Let's see. I don't know anything about you. I say you got fired from your job and have finally decided to write your novel. That's the sort of bullshit reason you'll find a man out in the woods.
Good night.
Welcome to the job.
Firewatch. I guess you're timed as to your the choices you make. Day one.
Hours of daylight to get some work in. I can see you at your desk, so call me when you're ready.
Okay. Answer radio call. Such weird controls.
Hey, sorry. Guess I slept in.
You got a relaxing, 14 hours of sleep? Whew.
Yeah, Jesus. I guess it's, 6?
6:45.
Whoops.
Don't worry about it. That hike puts everyone out of commission for a day or two. But now that you're up, let me quickly get you acquainted with the job. There's a thing in the middle of your room with a round map on it. Do you see it?
Yeah, I was wondering about this.
Okay, yeah, I see it.
This is the Osborne Firefinder, invented in 1914 by W.B.
Osborne?
You use this to spot, you guessed it, what the fuck?
What is it?
Nothing. You use this to... Oh, fuck me!
Good God, language, lady.
Out your west-facing window. Are you seeing what I'm seeing? Are those fucking fireworks? I need you to confirm. Do you see them?
Whoa, that's not legal, right?
No. You need to get down there right now and stop them. Fire danger is through the fucking roof.
Is that really my job?
Your job is whatever I say it is. Look, the closest ranger is like 2 days away. Go down there and set them straight.
Oh, I see the time.
Do you think you can handle that?
Do I write him a ticket?
Easy there, Dirty Harry.
Well?
Get going. You'll probably need a rope to get down the shale between you and the lake, if I remember right. There should be one in the supply box on the way. The code is 1234. It's actually that for all of them.
Convenient.
That's one word for it.
Okay, so I guess we'll have to find a supply box as we're going towards those fireworks. Read the map. Oh gosh, I hate reading maps. Okay, so where are we going? I'm assuming we're going that way, but where are we now? I guess we're just gonna go this way. Is this the supply box? No. Okay. Probably update our map. Take this note. Rotten. Hey man. Guy couldn't take it, so I walked up his lookout and put some stuff in the box. Found one of these bars you liked, hiking into the park, but let's get fucked when I'm back, Dave. Okay. I'll pick up the bar. It's a canola bar. Eat. Take. Okay, so let's deal with whoever setting up the... Hey, look, there's a pine cone. Drop. Anyway. I think the fireworks were this way. I think we're getting closer to them from the sound of it. I think. They are still going west, so... Yeah, there they are.
This shale slide is steep. How do you expect me to get down this?
I don't remember it being that bad. It's not even named on our topos.
Yeah, well, I'd go with Widowmaker.
Come on, it's really not that bad.
It's a 50-foot cliff made of rocks that look like... No!
Oh.
the hell's wrong with you?
Widowmaker got the best of me.
What exactly happened?
My rope snapped coming down the shale slide.
You didn't break anything, did you?
No, I think I'll make it.
Well, be careful for Christ's sake.
It is a hell of a nice camping spot down here by the lake.
I haven't been down there in years, but yeah, Jonesy Lake area is perfect.
Well, there have been people here recently. Drinking, too.
Oh shit, ferret or Irish. They left their packs tied up here.
The idiots down at the lake?
Yeah, them. I just found where they're hanging out. Finding a bunch of empty beer cans, they threw them all over hell.
Are you fucking serious?
Yeah, sure am.
People are just the worst, aren't they?
They're not great, no. Well, they left their clothes out to dry. It looks like two people. What if they're naked?
Won't that be exciting? Look, they're obviously still there, so tell them off and then head back.
He's like,
Found them in the lake, naked.
Skinny dipping.
Yeah.
Is that a guy over there?
Oh boy. Enjoy dealing with that.
Cool stereo!
Oh, hey! Put that down! Thank you! Now leave us alone! You're a creep! You asshole!
Light another firework and it won't be your stereo I wreck!
Oh, fuck you, psycho!
Yeah, fuck you!
I really want to do that.
Pay for this. You can't just harass girls in the woods. Let's get out of here.
I'm not gonna lie, I really want to throw a stereo in there. Okay.
Hey, that go okay?
It's done.
Well, that's ominous.
Hopefully there won't be any more trouble.
Good. Thanks for going down there.
Alrighty, let's go back.
Of a confession to make.
What is it?
Look, I was drunk last night when I welcomed you to the job.
Yeah, well, you're not the first boss to be guilty of that.
I know, I know I can get a little pushy, you know, putting you on the spot about why you're out here and stuff.
It's fine.
I'll keep that sort of a thing to a minimum. Anyway, let me know when you get back to your lookout.
Hey, I heard some thunder.
Yeah, I've got eyes on a storm out to the north.
Well, that's bad, right? Because of the lightning?
It just means we'll be busy. Hurry home, and try not to get hit by lightning.
Yeah, I'm not sure I got a lot of choice in getting struck down.
Especially not with your electric personality.
Oh, I'm just gonna let her have that one.
I will take that flashlight, though. Oh, it doesn't work. Oh, maybe some batteries it will. Oh. Yay. Now we have a flashlight. Nice. Look, a cave.
What's in this cave down here?
In Thunder Canyon?
Thunder Canyon?
Hey, I didn't name it. But in the cave? I don't know, rocks? NFS tells people not to go too far in there. It's pretty dangerous.
So,
I say, fuck it. You're a grown man, you can go where you want.
Great. Used to go caving with someone back in Colorado. She'd love to. Might be great to explore it sometime this summer.
Well, that could be fun. Obviously, be very careful.
This cave is gated off.
It's to stop spelunkers from dying without getting the keys from the Forest Service office first.
It doesn't seem that dangerous. Whoa, whoa! Ah, no!
Henry!
Seriously, it's completely fine in here.
God damn it.
Hello?
Well, I'm going back the right way. I've just been climbing. What was that? There's someone up here. Sketchy. Still climbing. That was a bad idea, going this way. It's quite the climb. It's the climb! Trail closed.
Generator is all the power I've got out here.
Yep, it doesn't go through much gas, and well, you don't have much in the way of electronics, so.
What about my hairdryer?
Oh, I'm sorry. You might just have to make peace with frizzy locks.
I could never.
Broken window.
What can I do for you?
Well, my typewriter is on the ground, outside of my tower.
You write?
Yeah, look, the wind? No. How the hell...
You should get inside.
Fuck me. Someone broke in.
They what?
They wrecked the place. Threw my typewriter out the window. Motherfucker!
Holy shit. I'll let the Forest Service know what happened.
So now what? Aww. That's cute. So now what do?
Okay, I put in a call.
That was fast.
Yeah, well, do you have any idea who could have done this?
Maybe that guy I saw in the canyon, but I don't know why the fuck he'd want to mess with my stuff.
Well, I'll have the rangers keep an eye out for a man hiking on his own and question him if they find him. I can't believe someone would do this. I worry about bears and fires, and that's about it. And now I've got to worry about some deranged hiker going after lookouts? Great. Okay, in the morning I'm gonna call my friend Patty, who works the desk down in Cody. They keep a list of everyone who's officially been in and out of the trailhead since, I don't know, forever, and see if we can get a list of names. We won't get much, but at least if anything else happens, we can refer to it and see if anything comes up.
Thanks.
I need you to feel safe out here.
Don't worry about it.
Oh, you can protect yourself, huh?
I just don't worry about it.
Perfect. Keep that attitude up and you'll have an excellent summer.
All right. Interesting stuff. So we got ransacked. We start day two and then probably cut off the video there here in a second. So, since we have completed one day. Oh, jeez, sorry, I'm stretching. I don't know how the game saves, so I'll figure that out once I'm done recording. I just don't want you guys missing anything once day two loads.
Wake up.
Okay, I'm gonna stop it here.
Hey, wake up.
Alright, let me pick up this stupid radio. Okay, I just got the trophy for a good first day. But yeah, I don't have to do anything for this part, so I'm just gonna, like, I can take my time responding however long I want. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. This has been the first episode of Firewatch, or first episode video, whatever you want to call it. Hope you guys have enjoyed what you've seen so far, and we'll continue on in the next video. So like, subscribe, comment, do whatever you gotta do to make a girl happy. Peace out, guys.